The Stanley Cup Final shifts to St. Louis, but a piece of the story remains in Philadelphia. Yes, St. Louis and Philadelphia have a number of hockey connections. They entered the National Hockey League as expansion cousins in the fall of 1967. Rod Brendamore was traded from St. Louis to Philadelphia in 1991. And among the current Stanley Cup finalists, Pat Maroon, originally a Philadelphia draft pick before becoming a postseason hero in his hometown here in St. Louis. And it was just 4 years ago that Craig Berube was still coaching Braden Schenn in Philadelphia. But one of the strongest connections of all is in song, one performed by the late Laura Branigan and played at precisely the right place at precisely the right moment, some 900 miles away from the Enterprise Center.
How does momentum start? A big hit? A timely goal? A hot goaltender? For the St. Louis Blues, a shift in their fortunes came in the unlikeliest of places. A bar in the shadows of the Wells Fargo Center.
We flew into Philly. It was a Sunday. We played the Flyers Monday. Times were tough for our team at the moment, and a couple of us have a good friend from Philadelphia. So he's like, hey, come out. We'll go watch a football game at my place and, you know, have some drinks, have some cheesesteaks.
That was January 6th. The Blues owned the worst record in the Western Conference and were coming off a game in which they surrendered two goals in 11 seconds in a heartbreaking 4-3 home loss.
This is a frustrating one for the St. Louis Blues.
Throughout the course of a season, you, as a group, you try and find things that connect you more, glue together you more, and, you know, it's... We got a call as the Bears were playing the Eagles in the playoffs, and a friend of ours told us to come and watch a game with them.
We ended up going to one of his local bars. It's a members-only bar in south of Philly, and we didn't really know what we were getting into.
A couple St. Louis Blues players came into the club. Great guys, all having a good time. They came in, we were just drinking, enjoying ourselves, listening to some music. We had our DJ started playing Gloria. They started listening to the song, they started enjoying it.
Every TV timeout, they turned the volume of the game off, and the DJ put some music on.
Same guy kept screaming, play Gloria, play Gloria.
So the DJ just kept playing it.
I think they kept playing it about four or five times for us that night.
Just the atmosphere in there, it was like a big party, so we're like, we gotta use this.
And use it, they did. The following night marked a turning point in the Blues season for two reasons. First, they inserted a rookie goaltender.
The main story for the Blues tonight, Jordan Binnington gets his first NHL start.
And second, they debuted a new victory song following their 3-0 shutout win over the Flyers.
How about that? A shutout in his first start in the NHL.
Binner got a shutout and we played Gloria as our win song. And
ever since then, we've been rolling.
And a Blues bench explodes.
Backed by the stellar play of Jordan Binnington and their new disco anthem, momentum swung the Blues' way.
Wraparound attempt, he scores! Sunquist, he scores!
St. Louis rattled off their first 3-game winning streak of the season.
The drive, rebound, they score! Tarasenko!
A couple weeks later, we find out that they're playing Gloria in their clubhouse. It's every win. We thought it was amazing. We couldn't believe it.
I didn't think that would be a win song, but you hear it a few times and you're in the room. It's a great song to be celebrating with the guys with.
Shortly thereafter, St. Louis set a franchise record with an 11-game winning streak.
Bring out the Zamboni! It's a franchise record! 11 consecutive wins!
That winning streak was big for us. That started things off, and we beat a lot of good teams in that streak, so it gave us some confidence.
With Gloria in their corner, St. Louis vaulted from the basement of the NHL into the playoffs and improbably to their first Stanley Cup final in nearly a half century.
You can bring out the Zamboni. The Blues will go to the Stanley Cup final.
Lucky enough, we've heard it quite a bit, so I think I know a lot of the words now, and you know, the song blew up. It's all around the city. It's been great.
Pack your bags, Gloria. You're going to the Stanley Cup final.
The bar where those visitors from St. Louis first became acquainted with their new anthem is known locally in Philly as Jack's. but perhaps there was a hint of its current importance in its previous incarnation. Yes, the former name of that place was the Blue Suede Saloon.